An impostor found a religion. An impostor couldn't build a brick house. An impostor, a liar, a cheat, the man of dishonesty, cannot build, as he has neither tools nor material with which to build. He can no more build up a business, a character, a career, a success, than he can found a religion or build a brick house. He not only does not build, but all his energies are bent on undermining what others have built. But his being impossible, he undermines himself. Without integrity, energy and economy will at last fail. But aided by integrity, their strength will be greatly augmented. There is not an occasion in life in which the moral factor does not play an important part. Sterling integrity, wherever it is, stamps its hallmark on all transactions, and it does this because of its wonderful coherence and consistency and its invincible strength. For the man of integrity is in line with the fixed laws of things, not only with the fundamental principles on which human society rests, but with the laws which hold the vast universe together. Who shall set all these at naught? Who, then, shall undermine the man of unblemished integrity? He is like a strong tree whose roots are fed by perennial springs and which no tempest can lay low. To be complete and strong, integrity must embrace the whole man and extend to all the details of his life. And it must be so thorough and permanent as to withstand all temptations to swerve into compromise. To fail in one point is to fail in all, and to admit under stress a compromise with falsehood, howsoever necessary and insignificant